Another story of another woman, Sumayya bint Hubat, the mother of Ammar ibn Yasir. She was a servant. She was a slave. And therefore, she was tortured by her masters for accepting Islam. She was tortured, her husband was tortured, and her son was tortured. Do you know how they used to torture people during this time? They used to dress them in clothes made of iron and put them on the hot sand 12 o'clock noon and leave them there. Not just leave them naked in the sand. It's like putting them in a microwave, putting them in an oven, because the best way to heat and to burn someone is to stick a hot piece of iron next to his or her body. That's how they were tortured. And it's not for a couple of hours, it's for many hours until the sun sets. Sometimes they would ask the children to fiddle with your eyes and put their fingers in your eyes until the eye comes out of your face. That's what some used to do, and this is in the books of history. Now this happened to Sumayya, and it happened to her husband, and it happened to her son. Have you ever wondered why Sumayya was the only person who was killed from the three? Because both male, the husband, and the son compromised and gave into what the mushrikeen wanted them to say. That Ammar ibn Yasir went weeping to Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulallah, they forced me to say that God was this small living organism creeping on the sand. And I'm crying because I said it. I had to say it. Allah is Ju'ud. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, but what do you feel inside? He said, Wallahi, I know who is Allah. So the verses were revealed. إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ. Those who are forced upon to say words or actions of kufr, Allah will not punish them, provided that they have this peaceful conviction in their heart that Allah is one. The point I'm trying to say to you, that they have already had the permission to compromise. This is number one. Number two, they have already been given the good news of going to Jannah. So Ammar ibn Yasir, when he compromised, he was already aware that he was going to Jannah. You are aware of Rasulullah's words to them, Sabran ala Yasir, fa inna maw'idukum al-Jannah. Be patient, O family of Yasir, because you are promised Jannah. So that means you are promised Jannah. The father compromised, and then he was exempted. And Ammar ibn Yasir compromised. Sumayya did not. They said to her, say Allah is this. She said, Ahadun Ahad. They said, say Allah is that. Ahadun Ahad. Until she provoked Abu Jahl. And Abu Jahl said to her, I know why you became a Muslim. Because you were attracted to Muhammad. Because of his good looks. She spat on his face. And she made him crazy. And he put the spear in her private part and he killed her. I am talking again about a minority. Not every man could bear this. There were lots of men that were defeated and compromised and went crying and weeping to Rasulullah. And that's why Sumayya is not famous for anything that she did for Islam except this moment, because she did not live to see Medina. She did not live to see Khaybar or Uhud or Badr. But these two moments that she resisted, these two moments that she spat on the face of this, were enough to grant her an admission to the minority club. If she had given in, if she cried, she would be like Ammar, she would be like her husband, she would be like X and Y and Z. She would be like the norm, the stand. This is high aspiration. I don't want you again to feel frustrated, because this is a special private club for private. You are welcome to go, but you need to be prepared for the conditions of membership.